Hi, I'm John DiBella, and this is your Classic Rock Update. And it seems that American Idol has worked out really well for Steven Tyler. He's got a new book coming out called Does the Noise in My Head Bother You? And in 1 week, he's on the cover of Rolling Stone and People magazine. In Rolling Stone, he talks about why he decided to do American Idol, about doing drugs with Joe Perry as recently as 3 years ago, and telling Jimmy Page that he didn't want to join Led Zeppelin 2 years ago because he just couldn't do that to his guys. As for his book, it's finally in stores, about 400 pages long, and Steven covers everything. Let's take drugs, for instance. One of the things we always put in our riders was that the promoter had to provide in the dressing room a full-length 6-foot mirror. I would take the local promoter's rep into the dressing room and he'd say, "Well, there's the 6-foot mirror you requested, Steven." And I'd say, "I can see the mirror all right, but where the bleep is the 6-foot razor blade?" Now, as far as the amount of drugs is concerned, Steven says he snorted about $20 million worth. As he put it, "I snorted my Porsche, I snorted my house, I snorted my plane." Now, as far as the band getting back together is concerned, even though 4 of the 5 of them were out in L.A., things are still not copacetic. He just wants everybody to get together. The hell with managers, the hell with lawyers, just fight it out amongst ourselves and let's get this done.
Ever since I was a young bird, I played the silver ball. From Soho down to Brighton, I must have played them all. But I ain't seen nothing like him in any amusement hall. That deaf, dumb, and blind kid.
Roger Daltrey is going out on the road to perform Tommy, but not with The Who. Now, you might recall a couple of months ago, we told you about the Teenage Concert Charity Trust, where he performed Tommy completely on his own with a special band. Well, he wants to take that band and the show out on the road, 15 dates, 3 weeks, only in England. We've heard nothing about the United States. Now, Pete Townsend's absolutely fine with this. He says it's great to see Roger out on the road with his band in 2011 and how he'll be there in spirit and gives him all the loving support he can. Whether or not we'll see these shows in the States is yet to be seen. In commemoration of the 25th anniversary of his death, the Rolling Stones have gotten together to pay tribute to their pianist and co-founder, Ian Stewart, as they called him, Stu, on a new CD called Boogie for Stu. You see, Ian Stewart was the sixth Stone. When the Stones were first together, he was part of the band, but Andrew Luke Oldman, who became their manager, said he didn't really look the part, so he became their head roadie and eventually the keyboard player on absolutely every album they did, with the exception of Beggar's Banquet. Now, this is the first time that all of the original Rolling Stones, including Bill Wyman, are together on this track, Bob Dylan's Watching the River Flow. That's what's been playing in the background all the time I've been talking to you. It's going to be a great CD, and I know you're going to love it. Now, speaking of the Stones, they have licensed their likeness and music for a new pinball machine. It contains 13 Stones songs, including Start Me Up, She's So Cold, and Mixed Emotions. And look at them jumping around there, a moving Mick Jagger target. Now, Jagger recently took time out from working on his new album to play the game in the studio in Los Angeles. If you want one for yourself, the cost of each machine is a little over $4,600.
Running over the same old ground, what have we found? The same old fears. Wish you were here.
Back in October, we told you that Nick Mason, the drummer from Pink Floyd, said there was going to be a rarities album coming in May. Well, it's May, and, well, it's coming. As a matter of fact, there's going to be a listening session this week out in Hollywood, where one of the things we're going to hear is this song, Wish You Were Here, but with French jazz violinist Stefan Grappelli playing on it. Now, once they have this listening session, we'll probably have an announcement of the date that the album is going to be released. But in the meantime, we will listen to this version of it, and I'll say goodbye. That is your Classic Rock Update for this week. I'll see you weekday mornings on the radio. Classic Rock 102.9 MGK.
Grr.